This video segment continues our examination of climate forcing factors. Here we focus on internal forcing factors, processes on Earth that influence climate. The major points of the segment are, number one, certain internal forcing factors, orogeny, epirogeny, and volcanism depend on tectonic movements of Earth's crust. Number two, albedo, the percentage of solar energy reflected, varies widely among different natural materials. Number three, Earth exchanges energy with its surroundings in the form of electromagnetic radiation. Number four, electromagnetic radiation can be characterized by its wavelength. Five, half of the electromagnetic radiation from the sun has wavelengths in the visible spectrum. Six, greenhouse gases in Earth's atmosphere are transparent to visible light, but absorb in the infrared. Internal forcing factors include orogeny, epirogeny, volcanism, albedo, and atmospheric composition. Often these factors operate in conjunction with one another. For example, volcanic activity may affect both Earth's albedo and atmospheric composition. The following introduces each type of internal forcing factor and evaluates their current influence. Orogeny, Greek for mountain building, is the process in which tectonic movements of Earth's crust or volcanic activities from mountains. Mountains, particularly with a north-south orientation, for example, the Sierra Nevada, Rocky Mountains, Appalachian Mountains, Andes, and Urals, disrupt global atmospheric circulation patterns that generally move east-west because of Earth's rotation. Uplifting of mountains also newly exposes rock that undergoes chemical weathering and absorbs carbon dioxide. Moreover, higher elevations accumulate ice and snow that increases Earth's albedo, the reflectance of solar energy. For these reasons, times of relatively rapid mountain building, say 40 million years ago when the Himalayas and Sierra Nevadas first arose, are usually cooler periods. Epirogeny is the formation of continents and ocean basins through tectonic deformations of Earth's crust. As discussed previously, global distributions of land masses determines the amplitude of glacial-interglacial cycles, and at the extreme may foster a snowball Earth. In addition, mid-ocean ridges, where most of the new plate material is produced, release large amounts of energy and greenhouse gases. Moreover, sea level rise and fall as new plate materials modify the shape of ocean basins. Orogeny and epirogeny proceed slowly over many millions of years. In contrast, volcanism can have an explosive effect on climate. For example, when Mount Pinatubo in the Philippines erupted in June of 1991 after 460 years of inactivity, it spewed vast amounts of sulfur dioxide and fine particles into the upper atmosphere. These materials quickly spread over most of the world and formed a haze of aerosols in the stratosphere that reflected enough sunlight to lower global temperatures by as much as a half a degree Celsius for nearly 2 years. Volcanic eruptions as large as Pinatubo occur only every century or so, but the smaller yet significant eruptions such as Mount St. Helens and El Chocón occur every decade. All of these eruptions release carbon dioxide, a greenhouse gas that contributes to global warming, as well as sulfur dioxide and fine particles that reflect sunlight and contribute to global cooling. The amount of CO2 released from volcanoes, however, averages about 10,000-fold less than from the burning of fossil fuels. Therefore, on balance, volcanic eruptions cool rather than warm the planet.